We have lot of questions on the right hand side. I don't know if we have the time. We can probably take another 10 minutes more for questions. We have a lot of food for thought and action. This is the first part of the art education conference where we have called on eminent speakers and special invitees to give us feedback, insights and perspectives on how, especially in the perspective of Indian education system, we can move forward into having art in the mainstream. We speak about interdisciplinary, we speak of multidisciplinary, we speak of transdisciplinary, but to implement all this, and it obviously starts from home, as just what Aparna said. We need to bring together, collate all these thoughts, bring it into a document. Just to let you know that whatever we've spoken today has been recorded, and we will be documenting every part of the Art for Education conference that we shall have. We plan to have the second one is on the 2nd of May, but I hope with Vijayalakshmi Akka's permission, we have at least 10 such 10 such sessions where we call on 10 such experts, and we build a good documentation which could be used by policymakers for the new education policy which awaits implementation. I thank you all. Akka, do you think we have time for a couple of questions that I see here?
Yeah, I think we can do about 3 or 4 questions.
There's one question from Sahana which says, will we be able to do justice to art which encourages a wholesome development of human being? I would like to know thoughts on this from any speaker. Sahana Kalale has asked this to all panelists.
I think I tried to kind of give a summary of that during my talk, that of course I made a case for music training, but it could be true for all other art forms. When we are talking about holistic development, there are multiple components that we are talking about. It could be cognitive, social, emotional, spiritual. So just music alone, just the art alone by itself perhaps can't be the answer. I think what we need is the translational research, translational aspect of it to various other components. Of course, if you take music, musical training, it would, as I showed in one of my slides, that musical training can definitely cater to various other components of development or aptitudes or intelligences, if you want to call it from various theories, like Howard Gardner's theories or something. But yes, how do we do justice? Like in any science, we have evidence that goes for our ideas. There are some challenges. Like for example, is it just a correlational findings that we are looking at, or is it just a longitudinal one? I think evidence per se, we need to do a lot more work. But from our own experience, yes, definitely, if you're talking about these components, art training, art education can definitely help in at least some aspect of it can transfer, near transfer that we say, to not just musical domain, but or art domain, but other functions. Yes, for a holistic development of a child or an individual. Yes.
Thank you, Dr. Shantala. Should we take the next question from Dinesh D? He has asked, where literacy ends and education begins for art in education to make a headway, particularly today in this globalized scenario?
It's a great question. And like I said, like I mentioned in my talk, educational philosophies have moved beyond literacy to looking at how you can empower the human mind towards creativity, towards leadership, towards having multiple agendas in learning, away from just literacy and being able to like reproduce a given structure of knowledge. However, I'd like to say that literacy does not end. Literacy is at the core of any meta-level cognitive activity. Even to make this sentence that I'm making currently, my literacy is at the core of my expression. So literacy never really ends. Literacy just stops being the end goal in any such maneuver, basically. So yes, arts and education, like I said, should move towards the 3 C's of education itself. Creativity, how to use arts as a means to like how can you use arts to like train children or adults for divergent thinking, problem solving, looking at how to sieve through restricted resource-based conditions. We are living through one such condition right now in the corona crisis, right? And this webinar is also a good example of how we are trying to make the most of it and trying to churn out knowledge for the future. So literacy just becomes the first step. And tutoring the mind towards higher goals of learning will be the final step. There's also a theory on it. It's called the Maslow's law, which talks about how, what kinds of knowledge education should look at. And just information is at the bottom most rung, and then applied knowledge, being able to solve something, is at its perhaps topmost pinnacle. So
thank you, Deeptiji. Thank you very much. Thanks for a revert. Now we have another observation from a professor of university in Delhi. And it's critical that music is not seen just as an activity, but a part of academic curriculum right from school. It is also important to provide avenues to the students to choose music as their career based on interest and capability to cover advances in technical areas of music. It requires advocacy at multiple levels of policymakers. If any of the panelists can respond to this observation. Prakash, sir, if you can answer this.
The National Education Policy draft does mention in about early childhood and early childhood care and education. It does touch upon this thing about pre-3 years, so how much of the arts the child should be able to get in a guided atmosphere, and between 3 and 8 years of age, how they should get, and so on. I don't think that itself is anything anybody is going to dispute that, but the problem comes at this level of at the point where it becomes academic. Then you see, like, what is the academic part of it? I'll give you an example. Now, the thing is, even if you don't know anything about music, you can have pleasure while listening to some music. But the thing is, when you don't understand why you got that pleasure, then, you know, it can be used just to manipulate you, maybe. Sometimes when they put music with news in India, you're being manipulated, but you may not understand that you're being manipulated. But that's why I'm saying it needs to come with an idea of critical thinking. Only then I'm afraid it makes the academic grade. Till then, it doesn't do it.
Very true, sir. Completely, completely agree with you. Thank you very much. Akka, I think now we'll wind up. And we've had a wonderful session today. I thank all the speakers, all the participants. And Dr. Vijayalakshmi, if you can add in a few words before we end the session, please.
Yeah, thank you all. And I hope this is going to let you all start thinking seriously about art and the role that it plays in one's life. And there were a lot of more questions, but I guess we don't have the time for that. We'll come back to you on the 2nd of May with the second part of the same topic with a slightly different angle to it. We'll keep you informed, and thank you all. Thanks all to all the speakers, to all the special invitees, and to all the attendees. Thank you very much, and namaskar, and we'll end here.
Yes, thank you. We close this. Thank you all.